On July 21st, Trollhunters: Rise of the Titans brings about the thrilling and highly anticipated conclusion to Guillermo del Toro's Tales of Arcadia series, including Trollhunters, Three Below, and Wizards. In need of a recap? Interested, but daunted by the task of watching all 88 episodes? We've got you covered. Here's everything you need to know before you watch Rise of the Titans.
You're gonna wanna see this.
Lively.
Tales of Arcadia begins with Trollhunters and our hero, Jim Lake Jr. He's a high school student at Arcadia Oaks, and he's pretty normal, aside from the crazy good knife skills. He lives with his mom, kicks it with his best friend, Toby Domzalski, and has a crush on one of his classmates, Claire Nunez. One day, on his way to school, Jim hears something calling to him. A glowing blue amulet. This amulet introduces him to a whole world of magic, trolls, goblins, and so much more that has existed under their feet all this time. Literally, the trolls live underground because they don't do too well in the sun. Now, Jim has the amulet. When he speaks the words,
"For the glory of Merlin, daylight is mine to command."
The amulet gives him a suit of armor and a sword made of daylight.
This is so freaking cool!
Jim has now become the troll hunter, whose job it is to protect trolls and humans, a mantle passed down for centuries, usually only ever wielded by trolls themselves. But wait, you're saying.
You guys are trolls, so troll hunter sounds a little like you hunt yourselves, you know?
Hunt bad trolls.
There are good trolls and bad trolls. Good trolls live in Troll Market, a beautiful underground metropolis that guards the Heartstone, a glowing gem and the life force for all of troll kind. Then there are the bad trolls, called Gum Gums, who were banished to a world called the Darklands long ago, with their leader, Gunmar, swearing to break free and take over the surface.
You will not disappoint me again.
Jim, now the first human troll hunter, teams up with Toby, Claire, and good trolls Blinky and Arg.
It's Arg. Three Arg.
To become stronger, learn to fight, and fulfill his destiny as Guardian of Arcadia.
You mean like a superhero? Oh, can I be a sidekick with like a cool superhero name like Deathblade or Sniper Snake?
Since Gunmar can't come out of the Darklands, he has to rely on changelings. Changelings are trolls that can take human form. You wouldn't know it, but they could be anyone, including Jim's favorite teacher, Mr. Strickler. So as if living a double life weren't bad enough, rehearsing for the school play to impress Claire, trying to pass Spanish class, dealing with Steve Palchuk, the school bully. Now Jim has to fend off Mr. Strickler, both from his plan to free Gunmar from the Darklands, and from getting a little too close to his mom. Mr. Strickler, who has fallen for Jim's mother, begins to have a change of heart, and eventually joins the Guardians of Arcadia to stop Gunmar. Now, Jim's human friends need a bit of a power-up. Claire obtains a shadow staff, a magic weapon that gives her the ability to create shadow portals, also once owned by the evil sorceress Morgana. No big deal. Toby arms himself with the Warhammer, a super cool crystal hammer that packs a serious punch.
Awesome sauce!
Ow!
Jim then gets trapped in the Darklands. And while his friends manage to free him, they leave a portal unguarded, letting Gunmar escape and enter the human world, where he plans to bring about eternal night, an endless darkness that would let trolls roam the surface. To do this, Gunmar must free the evil sorceress Morgana, Merlin's old apprentice. She's been trapped underneath Troll Market all this time.
Surprise!
As if it couldn't get worse, Claire's shadow staff, which once belonged to Morgana, has opened the door for Morgana to possess Claire and sabotage Jim's mission. They manage to exorcise Claire.
You don't control me!
And her connection to Morgana gives her stronger abilities.
That's new.
To complicate things, Jim and his friend's parents all find out about their double life. After some explaining, they're probably more okay with it than my parents would be. Eventually, Gunmar steals Merlin's staff from his tomb to free Morgana from her prison and bring about eternal night.
The eternal night is here!
But our heroes bring Merlin back from the dead. So, who really won here? Merlin equips the Guardians of Arcadia with armor and more power-ups.
Holy guacamole!
But insists that the only way Jim can defeat Gunmar is if he becomes a troll himself.
Consider this recipe my way of evening the odds.
He creates an elixir that turns Jim into a mix of human and troll. Talk about an identity crisis. Jim takes on Gunmar with his newfound abilities. But now, with Morgana free, the Guardians face her too. Using her own tricks against her, Claire uses the Shadow Staff to permanently trap Morgana in the Shadow Realm. The battle has been won, but the Heartstone in Troll Market was destroyed. Jim and Claire leave to find another Heartstone in New Jersey, while Toby stays behind to defend Arcadia.
Keep Arcadia safe. You're its only Trollhunters now.
During the final battle, we meet Aja and Krell.
Is she talking about us?
Two foreign exchange students who turn out to be royal alien refugees from the planet Bacaridian 5. While the Guardians of Arcadia were working to stop Gunmar and Morgana, Aja and Krell were a little busy running from a coup by General Mirando. Their story begins in the series Three Below, when Aja and Krell escape the coup with Commander Varvatos Vex to Earth, where they assume human disguises and attempt to hide out there.
Prepare to be destroyed, human!
All while repairing their ship and restoring their parents as they heal from the attack. Meanwhile, General Mirando sends bounty hunters to find the royals.
Set course for Arcadia Oaks, Ighead.
During their time on Earth, Aja and Krell attempt to blend in.
I think we have a very good handle on human food consumption.
Aja falls for Steve, Jim's bully, who's gradually becoming a better person. And Krell becomes fast friends with Toby and Eli Pepperjack, a nerdy classmate who is obsessed with uncovering Arcadia's supernatural secrets.
Trust me, anything is possible in this town.
Steve and Eli have even become friends of their own once Eli introduced Steve to his conspiracy theories. Together, they form the Creep Slayers.
Creep
Slayers!
Aja and Krell also get help from Stuart, a guy who runs a taco truck, and turns out to be an alien.
Oh, I am!
Aja and Krell fend off the bounty hunters sent by Mirando, who steal their parents from the ship and reprogram it to turn against the royals.
Welcome home, kids. Just in time to die.
After they get their parents back, Aja and Krell send hope to the people of Acheridian 5, promising to free them from Mirando's terror. All of this, as it turns out, is happening at the same time as Jim and his friends are fighting Gunmar and Morgana. Talk about multitasking.
Glorious! Glorious! You are encased in some kind of stony armor!
Gloria!
Arcadia's really been through it. But our alien royals are not only facing Mirando. Aja and Krell are also under threat of capture by a top-secret alien hunting facility, Area 49B, run by Colonel Kubritz.
You're not going anywhere.
Kubritz and Mirando team up, and he gives her a robot army and some sweet alien armor to help her fight against the royals. In exchange for her help finding Galen's core, the life force of an ancient god capable of creating or destroying planets. Where is Galen's core? Hidden in Troll Market, as it turns out. Mirando bonds himself to Galen's core and starts to destroy Arcadia. Kubritz realizes he's betrayed her.
I never should have trusted you.
And decides to help stop him, dying in the process. Aja and Krell go up against Mirando, now backed by the Acheridian army and the people of Arcadia, including Steve, Toby, and Eli. Aja and Krell's parents use their life force to sacrifice themselves and destroy Mirando. Aja and Vex decide to return home with Eli, who has been appointed Earth's ambassador on Acheridian 5. Krell decides to stay on Earth, where he has made friends and a home for himself.
The humans and this planet are lucky to have you.
Yes! DJ Clem is staying in the house!
In the aftermath of this huge battle, Steve and Toby are walking home when they meet a talking cat.
Beware. You are in grave danger.
This is Archie, the dragon cat assistant.
I am a wizard associate, thank you very much.
Sorry, associate of Dukesy, a background character we've met throughout the other series, who reveals himself to be not only a wizard, but Merlin's apprentice.
There's a lot about me you don't know.
Dukesy is over 900 years old. Please give us his skincare routine. And his name is a mouthful. Hizzardukes Casperan, or Dukesy for short. Dukesy brings us into the third part of this saga, wizards.
Magic fire!
In a bookstore?
So you know how Jim and Claire went off to find the other Heartstone? They got attacked by the Arcane Order. Three ancient wizards, Belrock, Skrell, and Nari, who plan to unleash raw magic all over the world and start over without humanity. Rude. Jim has been gravely injured with a magic shard that's slowly killing him. Merlin and Dooksie take them all to Merlin's awesome flying sky castle, Camelot. Merlin has taken in Nari, who abandoned the Arcane Order and has been in hiding so that they can't bring about the end of the world. While the Order attacks the castle, Dooksie, Claire, Jim, Steve, and Archie all fall into a time rift, taking them all back to 12th century Camelot. Steve becomes a knight under Sir Lancelot. Claire comes to know Morgana before she turned evil. Jim is locked up in a dungeon for trolls, and Dooksie replaces his earlier self as Merlin's young apprentice.
I know this looks bad, but I swear I've got this under control.
Over time, they learn why the Trollhunter's amulet was built in the first place by Merlin and Morgana.
At least you can lend a hand, eh?
How Morgana became the evil Pale Lady, and how humans first went to war against trollkind, led by Gunmar. All while they attempt to keep the timeline in check and avoid a total paradox that could erase their own futures. Easy peasy.
By my beard, not that bad, eh?
During the infamous battle of Killahead Bridge, where King Arthur and his knights clash against Gunmar and the Gum-Gums, Jim encourages the good trolls, including a much younger Blinky, to rise up with humanity.
We are here to not run away!
Jim also inspires Callista, the very first troll hunter, and the one who trapped Gunmar in the Darklands. Dooksie and Merlin take on Morgana to seal her away forever. Dooksie's got his own magic staff now, which he turns into something he's more familiar with. The coolest magic guitar ever played. Merlin is not impressed.
What do you hope to do? Blow out our eardrums?
With Claire's help, they get the job done.
I think we just saved history.
Now, back in the present, the Guardians take on Belrock and Skrell of the Arcane Order, who have armed themselves with a resurrected Morgana, King Arthur, and Jim, who turned himself into a full troll in an attempt to save his friends, and now has had his mind corrupted by the Order.
Evil beast.
Claire enters the Shadow Realm, hoping to save Jim's soul, only to run into Morgana, who's looking for King Arthur's soul. They form a truce together, but after Arthur kills Merlin, Morgana sees the error of her ways and officially joins our heroes against the Order. By destroying Merlin's staff, Dooksie finds the Genesis Seals, which, when broken, will unleash raw magic upon the world. Using the seals, Dooksie creates a time loop, officially named
Hizzard Dooksie's Eternal Time Trap,
and keeps Belrock and Skrell busy for a time, later fighting them off to keep Nari safe. Morgana fights King Arthur, sacrificing herself and leaving Excalibur for the taking, embedded in stone. Meanwhile, our heroes fight Jim.
Arg, remind Jim who he was!
Who is still a full troll and is still under the control of the Arcane Order. Just as Jim regains his sense of self, he turns to stone. But it's Claire's love that not only restores Jim back to life, it returns him to his human form. Jim attempts to pull Excalibur from the stone, but finds that he can't. And now, without the amulet, Jim wonders if he can still call himself the Trollhunter. Still, our Guardians return to their lives, vowing to protect Arcadia and the world from the looming threat of destruction. Dooksie takes off with Nari to keep her safe from the Arcane Order, who are now recovered and hunting her down. If all of that was a lot, here's the 30-second version. The town of Arcadia has been the site of both magic and alien activity. Jim was the troll hunter, but now his amulet's gone. Merlin is dead. Excalibur is stuck in stone. The Guardians of Arcadia are separated across both Earth and the galaxy. And Dooksie the Wizard is keeping Nari safe from Belrock and Skrell, who need her to complete the Arcane Order so they can unleash raw magic all over the world and destroy everything as we know it.
Thanks!
The question now is, how will our heroes stop the Arcane Order? How will Jim protect Earth without the Trollhunter's amulet? What will become of the Guardians of Arcadia? And just who, or what, are the Titans? Witness the epic conclusion to Tales of Arcadia in Trollhunters: Rise of the Titans, as our heroes team up against their greatest threat of all.
Let the Earth be
begin anew!
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.